So let me just go over these ABCs and Ls. So line one, basically, as Linux denied write access for OpenVPN, which runs in the proper OpenVPN underscore T domain, so that context is right. To write access to the OpenVPN dash status period log file, which has a type of OpenVPN underscore etc underscore T. So the type basically already describes the property of the file, at least what SNLinux thinks the property is. So SNLinux basically thinks that OpenVPN wants to write to a configuration file, the file in etc. Files in etc are usually read-only by the daemon, and so the file is misclassified because we're talking about a log file. And so the optimal solution would actually be to tell OpenVPN to write this log file to var log. Let's see what OpenVPN supports. So the OpenVPN file context specification file. And here you have it. So as Linux thinks, this file should be in var log OpenVPN start status dot log period log. So basically, the cleanest fix would be to just change the configuration file and tell OpenVPN to put this log in var log and then OpenVPN status log. That'll fix your issue in the cleanest way. Actually, let's have a look whether, because there's another issue. Usually, daemons don't actually write to the log files. At least that would be the best scenario, best case scenario. They actually, instead of writing to a log file, they actually append to a log file. And if that would be the case, then you could actually, you don't actually need to allow the write permission to OpenVPN for that log file, because if you allow it to write, then OpenVPN would be able to remove entries from the log file as well. And unlike append, where in append you can just add log entries to the file and not remove existing entries. So that's really a plus for security, for auditing. Anyways, let's have a look and see if so the OpenVPN status file would have a OpenVPN status T type, and that's actually pretty weird, but let's have a look what the type enforcement file says. So OpenVPN, so here, oh yeah, that is actually, this will actually work. This will actually work. So basically, I would say remove the OpenVPN status log file from etc, wherever it currently is, and then just tell OpenVPN to create it in var log. That should fix it. Then it'll be able to create that file there and to write to it. That'll fix your first issue. The second issue is where SELinux denies read, write, and search access to OpenVPN to the temporary directory. The name is temp, so that's actually slash temp probably, or maybe var temp, but it's actually just temp directory. Now this is actually a weird ABC now, in that search means to traverse, so OpenVPN tries to traverse slash temp, that's fine. To read means to actually list the dir, so we're talking about a dir here. So OpenVPN wants to actually list the temp dir, see what's in there, and then it actually also wants to write to the temp dir. And this is actually a weird bit, because if this usually means that OpenVPN wants to add a file to that dir, usually. Sometimes the write permission could also mean that it just checks for write access. But I can't see that from this single ABC denial. You would need to use audit to figure out whether this write permission actually pertains to actually writing to a directory or just checking for write access. But let's have a look in the policy and see whether there's actually support for temp. So there is actually here support for temp because there's an OpenVPN underscore temp t underscore underscore t type. So that means that OpenVPN actually should be able to manage this, and it actually this should actually be allowed. File stamp, file trans, OpenVPN temp t. This should actually be allowed. So that's kind of weird. let's see if there's temp t right to there. This actually looks strange. Because it's actually allowed, this is actually all allowed. So I'm not sure which policy you are using, but it's not the latest Debian policy most likely, because the latest Debian policy would have allowed this. So yeah, strange issue. Find out which version of policy you're running first. So the next issue here, we have OpenVPN actually trying to bind a socket, a UDP socket, to port 1196. Now this is something that I've seen before, but the policy currently does not support OpenVPN binding to any port. Let's have a look at the policy. Here we have the networking rules, and basically it's allowed here to connect to HTTP cache ports, so proxy, and web server ports connecting, but we're talking about actually binding. And here here we have actually a rule that allows OpenVPN to bind to OpenVPN ports. So what we need to do is actually label port 1196 with the OpenVPN port type, and that'll allow OpenVPN to bind UDP sockets to that port, and that'll take care of this issue. So that's se manage, and then port, and then dash a, and then dash t, and then OpenVPN underscore port underscore t, and then dash p UDP, and that'll enable you to label that port with the OpenVPN port type and allow that. So the fourth one is where as Linux denies access to OpenVPN to request the kernel to load the car major 10200 port, kernel module. And I looked this up, and this is actually the TunTap kernel module. So you should ask yourself, why is this module not loaded in the first place already on the system? And then decide whether you want to actually make sure to, make it sure that it's already loaded on the system, or that you want to allow OpenVPN to request the kernel to load that module for you. If you go with the latter, then you can just allow this rule as is using the outer to allow command. So you could basically copy this over here and then basically pipe this into outer to allow dash capital M, and then a module name, some unique module name, and then that all creates a policy module with the allow rule for this, and then you can load that into the system with the SE module dash I, and then the policy module name as a parameter, and that'll load that into the system persistently, and that'll allow OpenVPN to request the kernel to load kernel modules. But probably preferable to make sure that it's loaded already, I guess. Let's see if the policy, why the policy doesn't support that. Yeah, it actually supports this already, so you're actually using an old policy, and so you're not using Debian Sid, I guess, because Sid ships with ship with the latest ref policy, and that would have allowed this. So yeah, that's just a problem. You should, for some reason, yeah, I know that Debian wants to backport the Sid policy to Debian Wheezy or whatever, but that's not done yet. But so yeah, that's actually a problem there. Then we have the next two issues are related. So here we have actually SE Linux denying access to NSL CD to create and set attributes of a SOC file in /var/run somewhere. The location, the actual location is at inode 10582, where that SOC file is. So you need to actually figure out where it is, because there is a rule in the latest SE Linux reference policy that would have allowed this if the SOC file is created in, let's have a look, in /var/run /nsl/cd, in that directory, then that directory would have been labeled with this type, and that would have allowed nsl/cd to create a SOC file in here. And but for some reason, either because you use an old policy, that this rule was not, this file context specification was not there at that, with your older policy at that point, or your nsl/cd daemon package stores it maybe straight into var run rather than var run nsl/cd. Not sure, you should look it up. You should probably figure out, use the inode number here to find it, to see where, what the actual path is of the SOC file, and then determine whether the SOC file is in an unexpected location or whether the rule is just missing in your policy, and then make a decision on what you want to do. The solution depends on, really it depends on what the situation is, so I'm not going to speculate too much on this. But so here the last three access factor denials are related to locale dash alias. So that I would assume, so SE Linux basically prevents access to read, prevents access to the message to read locale period alias, which is located at inode 524820, but it's somewhere in /etc, because the target type, the type of the locale alias file is etcd, so that basically indicates that the file must be somewhere under /etc. And actually here the path in the third APC now shows you that it's actually an etcd locale alias. Now this file is most likely mislabeled. I'm just assuming here that this is a localization file, and with regards to localization, localization files are declared in the misfile module. Let's see if we have something resembling here. Not really. So the solution would probably be to label that file with the locale underscore t type. So you'd add a file context specification with SE manage f context dash a dash t locale underscore t, and then add the path of etc, and then it's locale period alias or something like that, period alias, right? Yeah. And then restore conet to actually apply that file context specification to the object, and that'll take care of that. And those are basically the issues involved here. Yeah, you're using older policy, so the policy has improved pretty much in SID, but in Wheezy it's an older, it's a bit rough on the edges. But anyways, those are just the issues discussed, and how to exactly deal with it depends on some of the answers to the questions. But these are all issues that can easily be fixed, and that a admin should be able to just fix. Just need to learn how to read these AVC denials. So a couple of things, these AVC denials have a lot of information, and you just need to be able to parse it. So with SLinux, it's always about interaction or operation. So there's always a source and a target in an operation or a interaction. And for example, here we have an operation, an active entity, which is the OpenVPN process, wants to write to a passive entity, which is a file, in this case, the file OpenVPN dash status period log. And the target class here indicates that we're talking about a file object, not a dir object. For example, the second AVC now, the target object is a dir. And here in this case, the target object is a UDP socket. So we're basically having a source and a target. And if the target is a passive object, then we're talking about an operation. And if it's a passive object, then you'll have a target class or of a passive object, file object, I guess. And if it's an interaction, then you'll have a target object, a target class of a process, because processes are active entities. So that's source, target, and target object, or target class, so to speak. And then there's some other fields in there. So for example, the com field basically tells you the command of the source process, so the command that spawned the source process. So in this case, OpenVPN. So you can actually correlate the command to the process type here. So in security context, has a type associated with it, and in this case, the OpenVPN underscore T type is associated with the OpenVPN command. So that basically tells me that the process is associated with the proper type, because, well, the name just basically is consistent with the command name. And same for the file. So here it says OpenVPN status file. This is a target file. And here it says OpenVPN etc/t, the target type. And so etc and log, it takes a little bit of knowledge of the policy, but it's not consistent. Etc file and a log file, those are different types of files. A log file has a different property from a configuration file, because daemons usually append to log files, but they will never append to etc files, because etc files are usually only readable by daemons. So that's that. And then there's some other information, the process ID of the OpenVPN command process. Then we have the device, and this is actually the location, the device on which the target file object in this case resides, and the actual inode where it resides. So if you want to figure out where the file is, then just look at the inode field and just use defined dash and slash dash inum, and then this inum, and then it should return the actual location of the file mentioned in the name equals field. And as for AVC denials where the target object is not a file object, so for example, here is the target object, it's not a file object, it's a port object. Because OpenVPN is trying to bind a UDP socket to a port with number 1196, then you have a few different fields. So here, instead of the name equals field, you have a source equal field, and this is actually the port number of the target port. And the fact that the target port has a type of port T indicates that it's a generic port type, port T. So the port isn't actually classified, it's not actually, it's just a generic port type associated to all the ports, so to speak. So the right decision here is to actually associate a private or a specific port type to it, so that OpenVPN has access to, so that you don't have to actually allow add rules, just basically classify that port properly, and then it'll be allowed. And then for example here you have a weird one where the target class is system, and that's actually in this case the kernel module. Actually the kernel module, it's weird, it's actually the type is a process type of the target. So this is I would actually argue that this is just an interaction, not an operation. But it just shows you here the kmod, the kernel mod, that it requests the kernel to load. So it's an interaction and operation. The system target class is an active entity, I guess. Sometimes it's not that easy. And then these are varrunt is a generic type for /var/run. So all objects in that location that aren't classified get that type, and that's basically for all the mount points in your root directory. At least they all have. So for example, /etc, by default, if you create a file in there, it'll get /etc_t, which is a generic type for everything on the etc. And then you want to decide whether you want to make it classified further and say, okay, this is, for example, OpenVPN etcd, and that'll just say, okay, this is not just a configuration file, this is an OpenVPN configuration file, stuff like that. Anyways, that's about it, I guess.